I'm so glad that they did the like opera thing at the end too, because I wanted to address that and I had already forgotten.
Yeah.
So
good.
Great. Like such a great song.
Such cool chords from like Jordan when he was like building up the song and building up the song. I love that dual guitar.
Yes.
That I think he was doing that with Jordan on the keyboards because I guess Jordan Bruders now sounds like a guitar player on the keyboard. It's amazing.
Alrighty. Whew. Okay. First thing first. Wow. I think the song was amazing overall. I love the drums, you know. Oh my god. What can I say? It's Dream Theater, right?
Hoo-hoo. Well, they topped and tailed that both ends with brilliantly. Got to listen to that a few more times, as I kind of already sort of said at the beginning. It's all right, isn't it? That's not bad. It's not bad at all. I'm very, very familiar with a lot of the Dream Theater repertoire now, and some of the pieces take a lot of listening to sort of to really sort of bed in and to for me to sort of become really familiar with.
And they're done. Whew. Wow. That is the opening song of this new album. And talk about announcing your presence with authority. That's like, hey, y'all, we're still here and we are still Dream Theater in case you forgot. It's not as melodic or epic as some of the other songs that I've heard from them. It's shorter. It's less than 10 minutes. But you know, I've really gotten pulled into this band emotionally when they have these sections that are complementary to the really aggressive, fast, rhythmic sections. And you get that some with that kind of transition into the major key in 6/8 and the slower 6/8 instead of like all of those 5/16s and 7/16s that are going everywhere.
Guys, maybe too much stuff inside. Of course, it's very difficult to react to something like that. 9 minutes, 30 seconds of stuff. So I had to listen to it again. For now, very positive. And maybe the vocals are just there because they have to be there. I don't know, that's my impression. But Mangini and Petrucci, amazing job together. And everything else works really well.
Oh man, that was the most I've ever enjoyed a Dream Theater song. This song is pure perfection. It really is. Oh man, everything about this. From the bass tone, it's incredible. The drum sound is huge and the playing on here is just incredible. It's out of this world. Petrucci's guitar solo. I mean, his guitar work in this whole thing is killer. That second guitar solo, that there's that first bit that I love, that's so good. There's all those minor harmonics in there. It's so tasty, but that second one has so much soul.
Oh, God. What an ending. That was beautiful. That was a great bass drop. I mean, everything was fantastic, and it's just so insane. Just, God, fucking A. Is there ever going to be a day when they don't have a good song?
Is that it? Is that all I get? Ooh, that last part, I needed it a couple more times, man. Ooh, that was really nice. I might be being a bit of a crybaby for that last pre-chorus. It's just, I didn't want it. I mean, it's 9.5 minutes long. You know, what are the odds that I'm going to fall in love with every single piece? It was fantastic. It was incredible. The production is there. I do think the bass is a little bit buried. Bass is my favorite instrument to hear in a mix. It always will be. So it always bums me out when you have someone like Myung, who's so good, and you don't get to hear him as much as everything else. I still hear him. I can still hear his bass lines, and they were incredible in this song. But
Jeez. All right. Got a few things to say about this. Let me adjust this microphone a little bit. Wow. Okay, let me tell you how we rate the song. 5.5 stars, greatest song of all time. 5 stars an A, 4 stars a B, 3 stars a C, 2 stars a D, 1 star an F, 0 stars. Why'd you ever record it? That's how we're going to rate the song. I've got a few positive and negative things to say about this song. Let me talk, you know, about the beginning of the song. The very, very, very beginning. You know, this part. When I heard that, I was concerned. I did not like that. It wasn't until the song was about a minute in that it really started to take shape for me. You know, I thought that the beginning was, you know, it was just, no, I wasn't feeling that. But then when it got into the song, the melodic guitar solo, then the vocal came in, and then that, what I consider to be amazing lead guitar solo in the center there, and the groove that was behind it, the syncopated groove that was behind it, which I thought was just outstanding musicianship. That's just me personally. You know, some of you out there might think it was mediocre at best. I know. I thought it was great. Personally, I just thought it was an outstanding musicianship. This, you know, this music is really fun to play. You know, you really can't play Dream Theater in a club or anything like that. You know, they're going to just look at you and go, huh? You know, huh? You know, what's that? It's just like, you know, if you're playing a, I guess you can play Rush in a club, but you're not going to play, you know, Farewell to Kings or Hemispheres. You know, you're going to hit them with the old Tom Sawyer Limelight, maybe YYZ kind of thing, or, you know, some of the older stuff, you know, Spirit of the Radio, Free Will, et cetera, et cetera. You're not going to do some epic 17-minute number. This song times it at 9 minutes, 32 seconds, and I thought it was good. I tell you what I didn't like about it, though. The video. I just thought the video was mediocre. I mean, you know, there wasn't, I was expecting to see, you know, like more alien creatures or something like that in the video. I can't knock the song, really, but the video I thought could have been more interesting. You know, I kept waiting on the video for something, and I got a phone call, and I told the guy, look, hey, man, I'm busy. Shut the fuck up. I got to go. So, and I was, you know, grooving on it, and I apologize for that. But we do live reactions here. I don't edit anything. If, you know, it's first time here, this is how I react to the song. I don't you know, I'm not going to redos or anything like that. This is what I do, honest reactions. And we talk about all styles of music right here at the Steve Champagne Radio Show. So if you like bands like this or other music, because I'm sure some of you listen to other music besides Dream Theater and things like that. So we would love for you to subscribe. Subscribe! Keep the channel alive. But let's get back to the song. You know, the drummer at times I thought may have overplayed, maybe. You know, because just when I thought he was overplaying, it seemed to fit. This is the first time I've heard the song. It's going to take several listens for me to really understand and comprehend all the breaks and changes in this song. You know, you can't listen to a song one time, as complicated a piece as this, and be able to go, oh, yeah, I know where everything is going. I know where everything is. You know, on a simple rock song or a standard, if you will, non-prog rock song, it's pretty easy to know where everything goes and the choruses and the hooks. But in bands like this, it takes several listens to get used to it. In fact, I think I'm going to make a drumless track of this. And, you know, for the drummers online that want to play to this thing, which would be extremely challenging. In fact, if you're a drummer out there watching this video, I'm going to post this drumless track of this song. And I challenge you to play it, because that would be a feat I would love to watch. Because, you know, we all love Mike, and he's not in the band. I get it. But this guy, he hammered it down, man. I mean, I don't know. There's a lot I can say about the song, but let me give you my rating here. I'm going to give this song a definite B or B plus for what it is in prog rock. I don't think I can go A, mainly because of the video. I mean, because I'm judging this whole thing, you know. You know, and it's a first time listen, and sometimes you just don't groove on the songs. Sometimes you get sick of songs quickly. You know, haven't you ever had a song and you liked it right away, and then the next thing you know, you're sick of it and you like these other songs off the album. So this is my first time listen at 9 minutes. My God, you know, I listened to it five times. That'll take over an hour. You know, it'll take an hour to me listen to this thing five, six times. So, you know, I don't know if I have an hour today to listen to it that many times, but when I'm driving, I'm definitely going to put it in the headphones. Not that I have a bad sound system here, as you can see. We definitely have some stuff here, but, you know, I cranked it up pretty good. I was shaking the walls. But anyways, what do you think of the song? Is this your favorite Dream Theater song? First time listen? Don't be a prisoner of the moment. Don't be a prisoner of the moment. A lot of people, band comes out with a new song. Oh, it's the best song they've ever done. And then 2 years later, they come out another one. Oh, that's the best song they ever done. Well, is this the best song they ever done? I'm giving it a solid B. Although the video, to me, I'm giving a C to. I didn't like the video. I liked the song a lot better. What do you think about that? Do you think they could have done a better job with the video? Put more aliens in there, a little more stuff, you know? I didn't grasp all the words to the song, to be honest, because sometimes the playing was so captivating. You know, I paid more attention to that, you know, with all and the rhythms were just like, wow, you know, it was pretty intense. But I'm going to make a drumless track, but I'd love to hear what you think down in the comment section below. That's what we love to do here, musical discussions, and I read every single comment. I might not respond to them, but I read every single comment when I go to bed. I just scroll through all my stuff and read all these comments because I love hearing and being educated by fans of music, fans of the artist, you know, talking about this, talking about that. It's really cool, musical discussions. That's my favorite thing to do on earth is talk about music because it is a huge passion of mine. And if you subscribe to the channel, you'll know why I like all styles of music. I know some of you frown on that. I get that, and I understand that. But I really don't want to see a stripper dancing to Dream Theater when I go to the strip club.